Neuropathic pain. Physical examination sensory tests.
Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Vagg, and in this short video, I'm going to be demonstrating some of the sensory findings that can help with a diagnosis of neuropathic pain. The patient who we're going to be examining today is called Matthew. He's a 45-year-old man in good general health who's developed some burning pain down the left leg into the foot, and some back pain as well, and that's been there for a few weeks now and seems to be getting a bit worse. The possible diagnosis of radicular pain is what we're going to test by doing some sensory examination. Okay, so Matt's on the bed here and we're going to be examining his lower limbs from a sensory point of view. It's always important to remember to test one dermatome against another and one side against the other. So I'm going to focus on the L4, L5 and S1 dermatomes on each side, which is represented by the medial part of the calf, the dorsum of the foot and the lateral part of the ankle, respectively. We're going to begin with light touch. I like to use the tip of the brush to test light touch, although if you don't have a brush, something like a tissue which can be rolled up is fine. So Matt, can you feel that?
Yes.
You feel me touch you there?
Yep.
And there?
Yep.
What about on here?
Yeah.
And there?
Yep.
And there?
That's a bit less there.
Okay, so that's a bit less. Yep. And then?
That's more.
There compared to there?
That's the same.
Okay, so it looks as though there may be some loss of light touch sensation consistent with an L5 dermatome change. So I'm going to move on now to testing pinprick sensation. I like to use a toothpick for this because many patients who may have neuropathic pain will be very sensitive if they have hyperalgesia. So you don't want to use anything that's too sharp because some of these patients may have a very heightened sensitivity to pain. I find that using a toothpick creates a sensation of sharpness with very little risk of actually causing significant harm or distress to the patient. It's very important to make sure that your testing is consistent to hold the toothpick so that it slips through your fingers each time that you touch the skin, and then that means that you're using a consistent amount of pressure each time. So we'll go again through our dermatomes with the toothpick. Matt, can you tell me, do you feel a sensation of sharpness?
Yes.
And there?
Yes.
And here?
Yep.
And here?
A bit less there.
That's a bit reduced.
Yeah.
And here?
Yep.
That's normal?
That's normal, yeah.
And there?
Yeah, that's normal too.
Okay. Yeah. So again, we have a reduction to pinprick sensation consistent with the L5 dermatome on the left. The last modality that I'm going to test for is one of the most important ones when you're trying to make a diagnosis of neuropathic pain. If it's present, it's a very sensitive sign that there is a gain of function change in the nerve, and that's highly correlated with the presence of neuropathic pain. The test we use for this is to run the brush dynamically across the skin. So rather than just using the end of the brush, one strokes the skin just with enough force to bend the bristles of the brush. This is referred to as a test for dynamic mechanical allodynia. So through the dermatomes again. Okay, Matt, can you feel me touching you there? Does that feel normal?
It feels normal, yeah.
And on that side?
Yeah, it's normal.
On this side?
Normal.
So L5?
Yeah.
And there?
Yeah.
Okay, so that, can you describe that sensation as I brush there?
It's pain, yeah.
Yeah, so that's painful.
Painful, yeah.
And right down to the end?
Yeah.
And then on the outer part?
Oh, that's okay.
That's okay, that feels normal on both sides. That's the same both sides.
Yeah.
Okay, so we've demonstrated in Matt the findings of reduced sensation to light touch or hypoesthesia to light touch, as well as reduced sensation to pinprick and increased sensation to dynamic stimulation with the brush, otherwise known as brush allodynia. These findings support the diagnosis of nerve dysfunction in the L5 dermatome, because they're anatomically consistent and will then provide you with support for your decision as to whether or not this is neuropathic pain.
The diagnosis of neuropathic pain requires a targeted history and physical examination, which includes sensory testing. Motor testing, such as strength and reflexes, may also be included. The light touch, pinprick, and mechanical allodynia sensory tests may be performed for all neuropathic pain presentations, comparing painful areas to non-painful sites or areas. They are part of the DN4, a clinician-administered validated assessment tool. The DN4 is simple and easy to perform in general practice. Other sensory tests that may be performed include cold, warmth, and vibration. For more information about diagnosis, including the sensory tests and DN4, go to www.nps.org.au/neuropathic-pain.